Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at using an external graphics editor with iPhoto and Aperture. So in iPhoto, you can certainly do a lot of editing or really adjusting of photos without leaving the app. For instance, I've selected a photo here. I go to Edit at the bottom and now I have a variety of options here, some effects I could apply, and a lot of adjustments. But say you wanted to do something like actually cut a chunk out of an image or paste something into it or draw a line or a circle or something like that that you would normally do in a graphics program. Well, you can set iPhoto so instead of going to this interface, it opens up the photo in an external app. Then you can edit it there and save it, and it will save it back into iPhoto. So let's start off by going into Preferences and setting this up. Now you have all these different preferences here. You want to go to Advanced and you see Edit Photos and you see in iPhoto and one other choice. Now a lot of people get stuck with this because they expect to see maybe a list of all their graphics apps here. But what you actually get is two choices, in iPhoto or with another app, and it will show you the name of the app. Now in this case, I had it set to Preview previously. I don't want to use Preview, but I don't have to. I select this one and it's going to come up with a window here where I can now navigate to Applications and select any app I want to edit the photo. So the thing is a little misleading. I don't want to go to Preview in this case. I'm going to use Pixelmator as an example, but you can certainly use Photoshop or Seashore or all sorts of other apps to do this. So now that we've set it up, let's go and select a photo and hit Edit. And instead of going to that editing interface, it's going to open up this image inside of Pixelmator. See, we're running Pixelmator now, and I can use any of these tools, filters, all sorts of different things. Just to make it simple and obvious that we're editing the photo, I'm actually just going to draw with a brush all over the photo. Great, so now I've made some changes, certainly something I couldn't have done in iPhoto. And the question is, how do I get it back into iPhoto, or do I want to? Now my goal was simply to create a version of this that I can then post on a website or send an email or keep some other way. Then I may not want to save it in iPhoto. In that case I would just go to File, Save, and I would save a Pixelmator file, or I could go to File, Export, or Share and export it in some other way and maybe save it and leave it completely out of iPhoto since it's not a photo really anymore but a graphic that I've created from a photo. If I want the image to go back to my iPhoto library, then the only real way to do that is Share and Add to iPhoto. And this would work with any Pixelmator image. It would actually just put it in your iPhoto collection. You could see it there as the last import, and I can see there's the original and this is the new one, the latest one imported, where I can see that it's been edited. Now you may say, wouldn't it be simpler to edit it in Pixelmator and then hit Command S and then it saves right back to iPhoto? Well, according to the Pixelmator website, they used to have it this way but received so many complaints from people that had their original photo changed and really wanted a copy in iPhoto, not a replacement for the original, that they just had to put it this way, non-destructive. So you can never actually change the original photo, which is always there. You can simply create a new copy of it. It makes sense. It's probably the safest way to go, if not the most convenient. Now I've changed it, so instead of Pixelmator, I'm going to use Photoshop. And now when I go to edit this photo here, it will open it up in Photoshop. I can draw on it in a similar way, use anything, any filter I want, and Photoshop works differently. I can actually go Save, just Command S. It does give me some JPEG options here because it's not going to save the Photoshop document back to iPhoto. It's going to save a JPEG copy. And then I can close it in Photoshop. And then I can go back to iPhoto and lo and behold, I can see that the photo has been updated. Better still, I can go to Photos, revert to original, and see that the original is still there inside this photo here. So just if I would make same thing, if I would make the changes inside of iPhoto, I can then revert to original as well there. So I like how Photoshop does it here, and hopefully Pixelmator will start doing it that way as well. Also note that just because you've set the preference to edit an external editor, or maybe you haven't set it that way, doesn't mean you can't do it on a one-by-one basis. So I'm going to do a two-finger click or control click here, and you can see I have on this photo options to edit in iPhoto or edit in the external editor. So I can still get to the iPhoto editor here even though I have it set as the default to the external editor, and if I had it set to as default editing in iPhoto, I could still go and access the external editor by control clicking or two-finger tapping on the trackpad to get to this menu. Now in Aperture it's basically the same thing except you have even more choices here. So you go under Export in the Preferences and you can see I can choose an external photo editor and I can even tell it what type of file structure to use to send to that external editor. So I can actually use native Photoshop document or a TIFF file which is less compressed than JPEG. So I'll choose in this case, let's choose Pixelmator. And now when I select a photo here and go to edit it, you see that I go to Photos and it says Edit with Pixelmator App. So I can do Shift Command O for that and it will export that, open that up inside of Pixelmator and you can see it's got the .tiff up there. I can make the changes to it and just as before I can export it or whatever I want to do, but I also have the ability to just hit Save here now in Pixelmator. So now when I go back into Aperture I can see it actually created a second version here in Aperture. So it's a much simpler process and I can see clearly that I've got the original here and the edited version here. And a similar thing happens if you set it to Photoshop. So there are the basics about using external editors for editing photos from iPhoto or Aperture. If you do a lot with your photos you may find this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.